careful what you hold near and dear to your heart. It's 4 a.m. world, Monday, the 16th of April, 2018. It's time to make it happen, people. Let's do it. More importantly, it's time to be honest with yourself. Not with me, not with your spouse, not with your family, your kids, friends and loved ones, or your boss. It's time for you to be honest with yourself. So what are we talking about? We're talking about all the trappings of life and success. There's a difference between that and living a new, bold life. And it's what I want to talk to you about today. So let's get started. Is it the house? The fancy cars? Your private jet or yacht? The fine jewelry? Or maybe it's money? Guess what, people? None of the above you can take with you when you finally do this. Close your eyes for the last time, never to have them opened again. You can't take those things with you, people. Not at all. Let's be careful what we hold near and dear to our heart. That house, whenever you pull up to it, do you have a sense of pride that's just a bit more than usual? Do you see your house, that big fancy house? You think it makes you better than other people? That house is here today and gone tomorrow. What if it catches fire? Then what? Or maybe it's those nice cars, those fancy cars you have parked in front of your house. Do you find yourself walking around them over and over? Do you find yourself more fancied just looking and staring at them versus actually using them? Those cars are here today and gone tomorrow. You could jump in one of them today and someone just writes them off. You can have an accident. Then what? Is it your yacht or your private jet? Do you find yourself walking around those, taking a look at it, admiring it just a little bit more than you should? It's time to be honest with yourself, people. Those material possessions are here today, gone tomorrow as well. Maybe it's the fine jewelry you like to wear. Maybe you like the attention you get when you have on a $50,000, $60,000, $70,000, $80,000 watch. The stares and the attention. Is it that you love? Those material possessions, people, are here today, gone tomorrow. What if a burglar gets into your house and steals those? They're here today and gone tomorrow. Or maybe it's money. Money is the most dangerous material possession of them all, people. It's the one. And I'm not saying this to say that money is the root of all evil, because it's not. It's the love of money that leads to root evil, people. Guess what? Money as well. It's here today and gone tomorrow. What if the stock market crashes? What if we end up in a recession? What if there's a glitch at the bank and all those millions disappear? Then what? Here today, gone tomorrow. All of the above, people, are fine and good. I'm not telling you that as we strive to live a new, bold life, as we become successful, as we become wealthier, I'm not telling you that it's a sin to enjoy those things, because it's far from it. Those things were made for us to enjoy. They are for us to enjoy. What's the point of being successful and wealthy if you can't enjoy what you've created? What's wrong, people, is when we allow those material possessions, the money, to take up space, real estate, here. That thing in your chest that goes bump, 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 that real estate, people, is reserved for your spouse. That real estate is reserved for your children. That real estate, that precious real estate right here, that's reserved for your family, your loved ones, your friends. Not for material possessions, people. Let's be careful of what we fall in love with. Those things are here today, gone tomorrow. What do you have left without those? Are you just a shallow person, only concerned with what you can possess, what you can hold on to? Your hands were made to grasp and hold on to your loved ones, not material possessions, people. There's a reason for that. Love is reserved for people, not things. It's so very important for us to have the right mindset as we become more and more successful. And that is the key to living a newborn life, people. It's your mindset. As you become successful, as you climb the corporate ladder, as you gain more money and power, be careful of falling in love with those things. They are called the trappings of life for a reason, because they are trappings. It's a fine line between enjoyment and love of material things, people. They're walking a thin line. And the only difference is your mindset. You have to have the right frame of mind before success. Before success, people. Not during or after, because that's a recipe for disaster. Money, of all material possessions, people, money is the most jealous, the most ruthless of them all. It wants your love. It wants your affection. It wants you to chase it. I know you've heard the expression, chasing the paper, chasing money. I know you've heard it before. It's what money wants. It wants your love. It wants your affection. It wants you to do this. It wants you to think about it morning, night, and day. That's what money wants, people. What do you want? Don't become a slave to material possessions and money. What's the point of being successful if you're not taking your spouse, your kids, your family, and loved ones with you? You can't take anyone with you if all the love in your heart is reserved for what you earned, what you worked for, what you feel is yours and yours only. You can't share it with them. You can't take them for the ride if all you're doing is this and looking over your shoulder at them and clutching onto your material possessions. It doesn't work that way, people. When the money and material possessions come and go, examine your life. What do you have left? Your spouse, family, and friends. That's if they stick around. That's if they don't get fed up with not having any of your most prized real estate reserved for them. You hear that? people. It's your heart. It's beating. But what is it beating for? Is it beating for your loved ones? Or is it beating for the almighty dollar? Is it beating for your fancy house, car, yacht, boat? What is it beating for, people? Heart, your heart, was meant for love of people, family, friends, those people that love you, not for inanimate objects. The mindset, people, let's be careful of that. Your heart is reserved for love, not for material possessions. You know what does last? Material possessions and money, they don't last, they come and go. What does last, people, we're talking about the heart, is love. Love is eternal. It doesn't go anywhere, people. And that you can take with you from this life into the next. Material possessions, no. What you do for others, the good that you do with your wealth, with your success, with your money, your precious money, that lasts. It's only what you do for others outside of yourself, with your success, that lasts, people, because it's done out of love. Love, out of love, people, love. That's what lasts. And it's the key to real, true, authentic success. Do you find yourselves, people, staring at your bank balance, feeling a sense of pride, having your chest swollen, the sense of pride? Be careful of that. Do you find yourself thinking about your money more than you do your spouse or your children or your family? Be careful of that, people. There's nothing wrong with money. It's an inanimate object. The house, the cars. So why do we love them so much? Be careful, it's what they want. Material possessions, they do one thing, they crave your attention. They're fighting for precious real estate in your heart. Be careful of it, people. Yes, you and I, we want to get to the next level. Yes, you and I, we want to be more successful. Oh yeah, we want to be more wealthy too. Of course. But the greatest wealth in the world is to fill your heart with love, people. Love for the people in your life, not for the possessions. It's a different P word, people. People over possessions every time. Let's remember that. That's the key. You want to impress me? Show me what you did for someone else other than yourself. Show me how you use your power, your wealth, to empower others. Show me how, as you grow, you take your family with you. Show me, as you become more wealthy and successful, how you share that with your spouse, your kids, your family, your loved ones. I find that impressive. I find that commendable. And I find that type of person to be living a new, bold life. It's your mindset, people. You have to think differently. You have to want success in the true meaning of the word. You have to get it in your mind today, before you get to the next level in your life, that you will not be a slave to money and material possessions, that you will not be found in that trap of turning your heart from what it's designed for into a dark place. You think being addicted to drugs and alcohol is a problem? Try being addicted to the love of money and material possessions. It's way harder to get rid of that type of obsession, people. Much harder. Why? Because those are the things that you worked for. Those are the things you dreamt about as a kid. Those are the things that when you became adult, you swore that you would have by any means necessary. You swore that before you die, you were going to be up here. You're going to be living the life. You were going to be the man. You're going to be the woman. You're going to be that respected person people looked up to. It was part of your dream, your goal. That's why. Because you had it ingrained. You did it. You ingrained it into your own DNA, into your mind, into your soul, that you will accomplish this, that, or the other. And you did it. That's the beauty of this, people. You did it. It takes that level of commitment. But what are you committed to? Material possessions that can't love you back. Material possessions and money that comes and goes tomorrow. Material possessions, people. Let's be careful of that. It's Monday, people. I think this is a great way for us to start off the week. The work day, the work week, be careful of what it is that's on your mind as you go through your daily motions, as you go through your life goals, what it is you want to achieve, what it is you want to possess when you gain success. Let's be careful of what we possess. Let's be careful of what we hold near and dear to our heart, that we hold on to like our life depends on it. Let's be careful. That's the way we should love our spouse, kids, and family, people. It's them that our heart should be bursting with pride for when we see them, when we touch them, when we hug them, when we hold them. And it's the same feeling we should have when we share our material possessions with them. It's the same feeling we should have when we share our money with them. That thing that we work so hard for. Those millions you have in the bank that you're so proud of. That you have a sense of pride every time you see all those zeros. Be careful of what it is you love. Be careful of what's taking up that precious real estate. Come on, people. Be encouraged. This much is true. If you are really and truly honest with yourself on this, you will open the floodgates for real success in your life. You'll take a burden off of your shoulder that you didn't realize you had. You will be free to love what God designed you to love. You will be free to enjoy those things even much more. Trust me on this, people. Those material possessions, that money, that fat bank account, you will enjoy them more if you release that grip, that iron grip you have on them. Guess what? This is the truth. It's the secret. It's not you that has the grip on your material possessions and your money. It's the other way around, people. It's the money and the material possessions that have the grip on you. It's time to be honest. It's time to come clean. If you step back with your chest like this, when it comes to your wealth and your material possessions, you're in trouble. It's time to be honest with yourself. It's the only way you can grow and move on. And it's the key to living a new bold life. That's what it's all about, people. Living a new bold life is more than gaining material possession, money, power, status. It's more than that, people. First and foremost, it's about a mindset. It's about what you have in here. It's about what drives you, what wakes you up. It's about what keeps you going. It's about having a legitimate reason for getting to the next level. And none of of it is valid. None of it is valid if you don't have it in your heart to take your spouse, your kids, your family along with you for the ride, for the right reasons, so that you can share all that you have gained, so that you can share what you've worked hard for. Guess what? They will love and appreciate you that much more. If what you consider so valuable, if what you consider so precious and sacred, you actually share with them, if you actually bring them along for the ride. The next time you do this, you should be holding your loved ones and family here and looking at your material possessions over your shoulder. That's what success looks like, people. This, your loved ones, your family, your friends, holding them close to your heart and making your material possessions jealous. Try it. You'll love the way that feels, people. We can do it. Let's make it happen. It's Monday, people. You have the rest of the week to figure this out. You have the rest of the week to be honest with yourselves. Don't let next week Monday show up and you head out the door to work or to your business and you're still holding your possessions this way and your family looking at them over your shoulder. Don't get caught in this trap, people. It's a tough one to get out of. Let's be honest with ourselves. You are responsible. I'm holding you accountable for being honest with yourself. If you truly want to live a new, bold life, this, friends, this is the most important lesson you can learn. We can do it. Come on, people. You have to think new. Be bold. Be honest. And then take action. Then and only then can you truly think big, plan bigger, and do everything in the biggest way imaginable, people, which is what we're going for, which is what we're shooting for. That's the end result. Do you want it? Do you really want it? Do you love your material possessions or your family? Make the choice, because that's what it is, people. What or who you love is a choice. It's a choice, people. Let's make it happen.